So I'm here with Sama Baegeen, the Hove Park Councillor, Conservative Councillor on Brighton Hove City Council. Going to be talking taxis, the taxi rank at Brighton Station. Where did it all go wrong? Because it's chaotic.
I don't know, Mark. Listen, so when I have to apologise if I get over animated when I talk about this, but when it was first mooted that the taxis were moved,
should move from the front to the back.
Yeah. I went on social media and I said two things. Guys, this will make the journeys longer and this will make the journeys more expensive. And there were a lot of things coming back with people kind of drawing suggested routes saying, no, the distances are the same and the cost shouldn't be that much more. And I think we now know, especially if you're heading east out of the back of the station, your journeys are that much more longer.
Yeah.
And they are more expensive.
Yes.
You know, in excess of £3 to £4. And actually, on a £10 journey to the far end of Kemp Town, a £3 to £4 extra charge is a lot.
Yes.
Is a lot of money. It's enough to put people off.
It's definitely enough to be. And yeah. Also, I mean, it's probably good for people walking. You're going to walk down Queen's Road at the front of the station and you're going to pick up a cab to go down North Road, aren't you? You're going to. There's an alternative option. So, a lot of the people I've spoken to, they've saw this coming. So, it's quite obvious that that would happen. So, and we should say that there were problems at the front of Brighton Station with buses trying to get out of the bus parking area there. So there were issues with that taxi rank at the front, but it seems that this is a sledgehammer to crack a nut, really, isn't it?
No, absolutely. And you have to go back and look at the remodelling of that one-way system now around the front of the station in a way.
Yeah.
You know, it really goes back to that, when all the buses and the taxis were funnelled into one side of the road and then come back around the other side. Now, taxis queuing, I totally agree. They were queuing all the way back to the Lights Junction where the new Leonidas chocolate shop is and so on. So it's actually becoming a pain. And one thing for sure, if you live out there, it is a pain because it's a nuisance.
Yeah.
Now, like you said, you don't then take a sledgehammer and you go, right, I'm going to find a solution. Because you could easily have come up with an interim solution like marshalling until you kind of figure out very, very smartly what you're going to do. Now, I totally appreciate taking the taxis out and freeze up that front of the station. Now, the railway folks came back and said, oh, we're going to do a nice, lovely piazza outside on the front. No, no movement, nothing's happened. Now, if there are plans, show us the plans, let us scrutinize them, let's look at the options and let's see what we can do. It's not about apportioning blame, whether it's the rail company, whether it's Brighton and Hove City Council, or who's. But I think the way things are at the moment, we really need a clever solution. Now, one thing, and I did suggest this in passing to a few people, there is a space underneath the station, which I think we can very cleverly use. They do that in a whole lot of places. But
is that Trafalgar Street?
It's off Trafalgar Street. It's a little street that runs underneath the station. I can't think off the top of my head what the name of the street is.
Yeah.
But essentially, it runs under that wooden walkway, which you kind of walk over to get to the rear of the station.
Yes.
You can then have some sort of mechanical stairs or some sort of ramp system that then takes you up to the station. Easily do a loop. Now, you do that, but you do that if you then want to do a remodeling of the whole station. In a way, that's something I think we should talk about.
Yes.
Because the station has had some work done.
It's a listed building, isn't it?
Over the years. Yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
But all of the work that's been done effectively has been done to the retail space inside the station.
Yes. And it is Network Rail's involved in this as well. So it's the council. I mean, who was ultimately responsible for that taxi rank at Brighton Station being moved?
Well, my information is, initially we were told it was GTR, so the company that's responsible for running the station. It then transpired that actually the council asked the rail company to lock the taxis out of the front of the station. So it probably is a joint responsibility for that decision. Anyway, but I think now we need to move beyond that and actually think of really clever solutions for that mobility question and that movement of people inside and around the station.
Yeah, OK. And going forward, what's on your agenda then, going forward as councillor?
I think, funny enough, one of the trickier things that came through towards the tail end of last year, it's now coming through again, is, and it's probably going to be with us for a while, is 5G infrastructure.
Yes.
The upgrading of
the ward, Hove Park ward, is it?
There is. We've now got another one on the border between Hove Park and with Dean, so that's coming through. I did seek advice when it first came up from Public Health England. I've now sought advice from the GSMA, the GSM Association, which is, if you like, the trade body for the mobile operators, and say, look, what do you guys have that we can actually use to make informed decisions, whether it's masts or equipment? I'm not a big fan of equipment and cabinets, you know, lurking in the landscape. I need us to come up with really well-designed solutions in a way so that these are not as visible and as clunky as they appear to be in the landscape. And then we can talk about the infrastructure, but we also need the agents for the operators to engage with us effectively.
Yeah, what about, just very briefly, the health effects of 5G? Should we be worried about them? Because we featured this on the latest news before.
Yeah, we did, and we had a petition come to full council, and that is on the agenda for the health board. The advice from Public Health England is that they're monitoring these, but for the time being, there's no adverse effect, but it's being looked at the Health and Wellbeing Board.
OK, we've run out of time. You'll have to come back again, particularly on the 5G issues. Sam, thanks for coming in today. Perfect. All the best for the next few weeks, and, Happy New Year as well.
Excellent. Thank you, Mark. Thanks. Happy New Year to you too.
Cheers.
All right.